Hey, 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 and welcome back to the channel, all of you 4 Degree of Freedom motion simulator platform build enthusiasts. Well, I'm here to have a bit of a chat about what you see before you here, the Dr. ADHD 4 Degree of Freedom motion simulator platform. This is a motion simulator platform that I've recently completed of my own design, and look, if I do say so, it's pretty kick-ass. It's a really tough industrial-grade motion simulator platform that I built. Originally started out as a 3 Degree of Freedom motion sim, just with the two front motors that control pitch and roll, and a rear motor that controlled traction loss. So recently I upgraded, and as you can see here, I've upgraded this now to a 4 Degree of Freedom motion sim. You can see the electric motor there. It's a wiper motor on the left-hand side there, and the trolley rail system here. And this has enabled me to add a surge axis to emulate hard braking, hard acceleration. If you're in a flight sim, climbing, diving, rolling, I use this simulator a lot for flight sims. I play a lot of Microsoft Flight Simulator X, really enjoy the Microsoft Flight Sims. Still got to get hold of the 2020 series, but it's on my bucket list. And I play a lot of the IL-2 Sturmovik Combat Series flight sim on this. It's a cracking simulator for a flight sim because of its large range of motion. That surge axis really comes into play and adds a fantastic level of immersion. Now, I've picked a Mark IV GT40 for my demonstration in this video because it's got 500 odd horsepower, so it really shows the surge fantastically when you really put the foot on the gas. And so that's the reason for this particular demo, running around Le Mans with a bunch of mid to late 60s cars for this video. So I have a 20 plus part tutorial series I'm about to release on my channel, a step-by-step guide on how to build this motion simulator platform. It will go through everything you need to build this. I'm going to teach you how to measure all your metals, how to cut your metals, and how to weld your metals. I'll teach you about everything that you need to obtain to build this motion platform, including all of the technical side of it, all of the motors, all of the electronics. I'll take you through everything. I'll show you how to wire everything up. I'll show you how to wire up all the electronics using Arduino Uno R3s, how to use a Sabretooth 2x32, and I use IBT2 controllers as well, so three controllers in total. But I'll show you how to use all the software and everything like that that you need to get this whole thing running from scratch. Now, budget, guys. You have to expect to pay around $2,500 Australian to build this, but that includes everything, okay? Including all of your tooling that you would need, including a welder, including angle grinders, a drill, and all the tooling and materials that go with that. All your fasteners, all your metals, the whole kit and caboodle for $2,500. If you put that in context with what you'd need to pay for a commercial motion sim platform, say a DOF Reality, for example, their 3 Degree of Freedom, for me to land that and ship that in Australia, that would have cost me about $6,000 Australian. So this is quite a budget-friendly motion simulator. So keep an eye out on the channel, guys. Very shortly, I will release video one of the tutorial series to build this, making our way through the whole series, bottom plate, mid frame, top frame, to completion. I'll teach you how to paint it. I'll teach you how to prep all of your metals for painting. I'll give you some clues on the best paint to use. Obviously, color choice is gonna be entirely up to you. So I really appreciate the sub, guys. Until I see you guys in the tutorials, you stay safe, you stay healthy, and you take it easy out there.